What she doesn't have yet, because she's so very young, is any power to produce. So there's no English to the voice.
And Chloe,
that,
that Chloe,
she must,
Chloe,
she must not Chloe, be pushed too soon, because otherwise any voice that she has there will be destroyed.
Yeah.
We all think that you've got really amazing potential, because to be... You are, as you know, very young, but what you've done has impressed us very much, and I think what we'd like to do is suggest that you go on working very hard at your voice and go on with your voice lessons, and Vinny will keep in touch with you, because we'd like to keep in touch with you in 2 or 3 years. Who knows?
So we'll definitely keep in touch.
He seemed pretty pleased with me. He was very nice and said that he wanted to keep in touch with me.
Did he ask you what your ethnic background was?
Yeah, he asked me.
What'd you tell him?
Chinese, Korean, Irish, Cherokee, Indian.
She's going to risk her life. The important thing is that she's so determined to give her son a good life that she's killed a man. And she's now about to escape Vietnam. She's going to become a boat person.
You I cradle in my arms. You asking as little as you. As you can.
So, she's a very strong, determined, tough character in a way, as well as being that very honest. She goes through a lot. She goes through the works.
You feel secure enough with the music to do it here, instead of doing it by the piano? So. It's okay. You can hold the
okay.
Here. Okay, let's do it then.
You who I cradled in my arms, you asking as little as you can. Little snip of a little man. I'd give my life for you. You didn't ask me to be born, you. Why should you learn of war or pain? To make sure you're not hurt again.
How do you become an actor?
Well, that's the $64,000 question. It's a terribly difficult and notoriously difficult thing. You can't get work unless you're a member of Equity, and you can't join Equity unless you get work. It's crazy.
Hello.
Before we start, I could want to ask a favor of you, please.
What?
Could you autograph this for me?
This photograph. Oh, right. Je le sais. Pour Léa, ils sont talents. Pour Léa, who is very talented.
Thank you.
So, I'm going to teach you the first song. This one. It's a duet. Mm-hmm. I'm going to sing the boy part. It's Chris. And you will be Kim.
Okay.
All right?
Okay.
So I start. With the lyrics, okay?
Okay.
Yeah. Where? No, you don't hold them
like that.
I'll hold them
like that if you can.
As you can.
life for you.
Well, they said that there was going to be an assessment. They were going to make us work, I think. We were going to learn more songs from the show, Miss Saigon.
They wanted to see us again.
They wanted to see us, I think, on how we looked on the stage. And
that's about it.
They were pretty vague. They don't tell us anything.
It's taken about nearly a year and at least a crate of scotch for us to get to the end of this. And it went through many convolutions. In fact, the first pile of roughs I saw, I was in Sydney doing Les Mis, wasn't I? And they were all couriered out to me. And we went backwards and forwards and for months developing it. I think it's the longest one we've ever had. This was the 1920s version. No, Miss Butterfly. That is going to turn up at a restaurant around the corner. No, this was the 1920s one, wasn't it? Yes. Yeah. World of Woozy Soul.
Yeah, what else? Very much sort of conditioned by the fact that it was a Madame Butterfly story originally. That's why this sort of
and then
developed.
The idea of the sun came in, which we kept, and the moonlight was to make it romantic. Gosh, this was when we were going to do it in America first, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm.
But it took it too near Madame Butterfly, whereas actually Madame Butterfly is just the jumping off ground for what Alain and Claude-Michel have written. Then Russ did masses of scribbles.
Like they did these.
And they... Which were part of the helicopter.
Mm.
And it started to become the hieroglyphic. Oh, that was the same time we were working on the background. That was the time when when the graphics sort of moved into the sun, and I wanted to get a woman's face into it. We felt it was a good idea, and this was an attempt here.
Mm-hmm.
Russ had the brilliant idea of putting the face into the slipstream. It was the only place that you could hide it, and you wouldn't see it, and then once you saw it, you'd always see it. And this became the final version. The great thing is that I know when it's going to be right, but what I usually, I never know quite what's missing. I know something is missing. And the great thing between Russ and I is that Russ will always take out of all the garbage that I throw at him, he will find a lateral application for what I've said, which I would never think of. And nobody would ever think of. Only the famous nozzle thinks of it. And that's what makes them brilliant.
Position for the girls, and then we go into the club by opening up like this and bringing this.